I was not prepared.
I'm honestly terrified.
It is what it is.
Cringe worthy. Hi guys, my name is Avia Eileen.
Hi, my name is Shane Stinson.
Hey, I'm Asia.
I'm Juliana, and today we are going to be wearing bodycon dresses for the entire day.
My style is very queer. It is eccentric and colorful with just a cherry of dapper on top. I have not worn a dress in over 12 years. As a trans man, it's always made me feel uncomfortable to wear a dress, but I've been medically transitioning for about 7 years now.
Can't remember the last time I have worn a bodycon dress. This pandemic has really deterred me from doing that. I'm gonna see if I find anything that I would be willing to wear.
I would describe my style as pretty eclectic and colorful. I like a lot of pattern. I don't do fitted. And part of that is because I'm not sure I would like the shape on me. And part of it is I feel like it doesn't fit into my personal style. Like when I think of bodycon, I think of that kind of like neutral colored Kardashian look. And I feel like that's not me.
Bodycon dresses are never on my radar. Anytime I've been shopping for like going out, which, fun fact, I haven't really gone out in the past like 2 or 3 years. Bodycon dresses can be intimidating because like in the photos, it's normally girls with like really big boobs or really nice butt.
Now, what I am doing is shopping.
Bodycon dress. I'm gonna put plus size on there as well. Okay, I am just now realizing what I have signed up for.
I'm trying to find one that's like kind of casual, or at least not like nightclub looking. This one I actually like because it has the tie in the front, so I can kind of cheat it.
So I think I'm gonna get this blue dress. It looks sophisticated, not too revealing, which is important to me.
This is exactly a Shane Stinson type of dress. How do I even start thinking about sizing? Clothing that is more stereotypically feminine, I have to go up a size, so usually like a 2X.
You know what, sometimes I'm like afraid of like being roasted. Someone telling me I look like a big ass cheetah or something. This looks stretchy. I'm gonna go for this.
The dress is here.
I'm honestly terrified.
It's very bold, very like, artiste. I hope this will fit.
It looks a little too big, but you never know.
It seems very sheer, very costume material, I want to say. That's not scary at all, but I do like the color.
It is tight, but there is some give, and I immediately have a wedgie, and I was like, should I just like not wear underwear today?
Was not prepared. I was not prepared about how cute this was going to look. Look at how cute this is. This pattern. And surprisingly, I don't feel nearly as dysphoric as I thought I was going to. That is just such a testament to how much work I have done on feeling at home in my body and loving my body and the gift of being able to transition medically. It just shows how much I can really embrace that clothing has no gender.
It is pretty see-through, the tie not making it not a bodycon dress. It is very see-through.
Not too revealing, which I like. But I will say this looks like something my mom would wear if she had some type of PTA meeting after work.
Because I'm incredibly lame, I searched cool aesthetic makeup on Pinterest and they gave me the idea to do cut crease. So I have this little cropped cardigan on now because I feel like this is cute and doesn't cover up like my midsection.
Paired this dress with one of my favorite pieces in my closet, which is a velvet blue blazer. I borrowed these wonderful earrings from my fiance and they just match this dress perfectly. Then I topped things off with a beret and gave myself some black boots as well. And as a transgender man who is plus size, if you ever told me that I would have a bodycon dress in my wardrobe, I would have told you you were fibbing. But look at me now. I am here for this outfit.
My old woman side part matches my old woman dress because apparently Gen Z hates side parts.
I do feel mad cute in this dress. I'm not gonna front.
This is so weird to me. This is so weird.
I'm gonna take some pictures on my block and in front of people, not in my house and not in my yard. And we'll see if I get more used to it. I'm kind of used to it, but I have the urge to cover up. So I'm gonna try to fight that.
I am gonna go show my fiance how it looks. So let's see, let's go over this way.
This is different. This is nice. Like, I haven't seen your shape besides you being in like hoodies and like long pants. So
I'm about to go to the grocery store with my roommate, so we will test it out there.
Successful grocery run. Nobody complimented me, but nobody insulted me either, so that's good.
I just left the gas station, the place that I was dreading the most to go, for obvious reasons. Cringe worthy.
I do feel like I look good in this, so there is a boost of confidence in that, but I would feel that way even if I was wearing like a really fly like bomber jacket or something, you know what I mean? In the future, for like events or parties or any occasion in which I would need to be dressed up, I might consider looking at bodycon dresses.
I actually did like it a lot more than I thought I would. It's really fitted, but I kind of got used to that over time. I might have to try bodycon more often. I might be a convert.
At the end of the day, this definitely inspires me to just wear dresses more often. I feel like this gave me a good place to start.
Definitely be adding this bodycon dress to my wardrobe, and I think it's going to be a very sentimental and monumental piece, and I will definitely be wearing it again. This experience really reminded me that I should never let society's expectations of what is masculine or what is feminine or what men are supposed to wear or what women are supposed to wear, I should never let those ideas and those thoughts limit me from expressing myself in the ways that bring me freedom and in the ways that make me feel empowered in my identity and in my body. Wear whatever you want. Wear what makes you feel powerful. Wear what makes you feel at home in your identity and in your body and in your expression.